Students, now we are going to start with practice set 2.2. Okay, see the first step. In figure, y is 108 degrees, x is 71 degrees. Question is, are the lines m and n are parallel? That means we have to check whether these two lines are parallel. Justify, that means we have to give reason for it. Okay, now you can see here that x and y, they are on the same side of the transversal. So let's find out their sum. So we will write here solution. X plus y equals to 71 plus 108. So I'm getting it as 179 degrees. So x plus y is 179 degrees. That means x plus y is not equal to 180 degrees. Okay. So it is not satisfying the interior angle. So you have to write here reason. Angle x and angle y are interior angles on same side of transversal. Okay, so interior angle test is not satisfied. So you will note down this sum. Let's see a second sum. Students, if angle A is congruent to angle B, as shown in the figure, these two angles are congruent. So prove that line L is parallel to line M. Okay, so we are going to write the proof. So if you look at A and B, they are not a standard angle. Okay, that we can define as alternate or corresponding or interior. So we are going to assume here one more angle as C, okay, which is vertically opposite to this angle, okay, angle A. So I will write here, assume angle C as shown in figure. Okay, so now with this assumption, I can write here, because A is congruent to B, so I will first write here, angle A is congruent to angle C. Reason, vertically opposite angles. Okay, so these two angles are congruent, reason has to be written, vertically opposite angles. And what is given to me? Angle A is congruent to angle B. You will write here reason given, isn't it? So from these two statements, okay, I can conclude, therefore angle B is congruent to angle C. Okay, now if you see B and C, they both are corresponding angles. So you can write here corresponding angles are congruent, therefore line L is parallel to line M. Okay, reason, corresponding angle test. We have already proved this theorem. So if corresponding angles are congruent, then we can see that lines are parallel. Okay, so you will note down this sum. Students, now we are going to do third sum. You can see the figure. From figure, you can see angle A is congruent to angle B, angle X is congruent to angle Y. This is our given data. We have to prove that line L is parallel to line N. That means line L is parallel to line N. This is to be proved. Okay, so let's start with the given data first. What is given to me? Angle A is congruent to angle B. I will write here reason given, isn't it? So if you look at A and B, A and B are corresponding angles. So that means given data says that corresponding angles between L and M are congruent. So I can write here line L is parallel to line M. Okay, reason corresponding angle test. Corresponding angle test. I will mark this segment as 1. Now look at the second data given here. Angle X is congruent to angle Y. Again, you should write here reason as given. Okay, if you look at angle X and Y, okay, they are alternate angles. That means on the either side of the transversal. So if alternate angles are congruent, I can say M and N are parallel. So line M is parallel to line N. This is statement number 2. So here reason is alternate angle test. Okay. So now I can write therefore from 1 and 2. If you see here, L is parallel to M and M is parallel to N. That means mutually L and N are also parallel. So I can write here line L is parallel to line N. Okay. Reason from 1 and 2. Is it clear? Take a recap. A is congruent to B. This is given to me. So by corresponding angle test, line L is parallel to line M. Then angle X is congruent to angle Y. This is also given. So by alternate angle test, line M is parallel to line N. By comparing 1 and 2, I can say that line L is parallel to line M, which is to be proved. Okay? Note down the sum.